welcome everybody to the Palace at Auburn Hills, Michigan for the Magic's Round Ball Classic. We're delighted to have with you the West All-Stars against the East All-Stars. Hi everybody, I'm Dave Sims. Good to be with you as we look at some of the premier high school talent in America. They're going to change the fortunes of a lot of college programs coming up in the next year, no question about it. And one of the big stories today is Lamar Odom. And Dick Vitale is working with me today. And Dick, Lamar Odom, no for Connecticut, no for Kentucky, and no for the pros he chose.
He chose UNLV, and I know Billy Bano and company, the coach at UNLV, has got to be smiling. I mean, to get a Lamar Odom, a multi-dimensional player, very versatile, this guy's got a world of talent, but he also has Edwin Greeny Daniels, who's from Louisiana, who's in the game, and he's an outstanding defensive player, and he's a point guard. So what a combination he's bringing down to Running Rebels land.
That is going to be something else. Now we look to another young man, Tracy McGrady, out of Durham, North Carolina. He has chosen to go the professional route.
Yeah, he has chosen to go to the NBA, and certainly a guy that brings a lot of talent. He's a guy very versatile. They call him Mr. Versatility. Came on strong during the summer at the ABCD camp, rated very high by all the gurus who rate players, and he's going to be evaluated here today. There's a host of NBA guys. I'm a little prejudiced or biased, and maybe that's the word. I wish he was going to college, but certainly we wish him all the luck going on to the NBA.
Some of the best talent in America right here in Auburn Hills at the Palace. We're going to meet them as well. We're going to talk to Magic Johnson, who's going to coach both of the teams in their respective halves. The starting lineup's coming your way right after this timeout. Back here at the Palace at Auburn Hills, it's Magic's Round Ball Classic here on the Deuce. And we look at the starting lineups for both clubs. We've got Bruner, Bell, Guest, Davis, and Johnson for the West Club. And Grace, who was an alternate, a local kid, brought in. We'll develop that story as we go along. Griffin, McLean, Morris, and Eli. We'll get to meet all of these players during the course of this afternoon. And Dick, a lot of great players have come through this game. Shaquille O'Neal, Moses Malone, to name a couple, in its previous incarnation as the Dapper Dan class started by Sonny Vaccaro. And there's a look at Magic Johnson. Certainly, everybody's happy to hear the news about him, that the AIDS virus has been significantly reduced to almost undetectable levels. You take a look at the coaches.
Wayne McLean, outstanding, won four state championships in a row. Peoria Emanuel out in Illinois. And he wants a job coaching on a collegiate level. I mean, that guy should be ready. You look at his resume. Four state championships in a row, Dave. Magic was in awe. He was sitting at the table with me last night at the banquet. He said, wow, he belongs in college.
Do you find that some athletic directors show reluctance to go with high school coaches?
Oh, definitely. But I think that some college head coach would be wise to be able to hire someone like a McLean. He certainly has proven he can work with young people. He had a tremendous run there. His son, outstanding player, and so is Marcus Griffin, both going out to Illinois.
Some terrific talent here coming out right now. Chris Burgess
was an early
in the West Club and going to Duke.
Yeah, well, Magic Johnson spoke highly of him last night, said he played with him, which I did not know. Said he played with him on a regular basis out there at UCLA. Certainly UCLA would rather see him staying there than going out with the Dukies.
Chris Burgess also read an absolutely fantastic letter to Magic Johnson detailing Chris's feelings about and his gratitude for what Magic had done for him, and including a 16-year-old kid playing with a bunch of, you know, the pros and college players a few years ago.
Well, Magic always invites a lot of young people down there to work out. I was there when he invited Tracy McGrady, told him that he can join him in workouts, gave him his number. I thought his speech was awesome last night. I know I really enjoyed speaking to the group and introducing Magic, but I'll tell you, Dave, you only wish that every youngster could have been part of that banquet last night.
The thing that Magic talked about, he says, listen, I'm a talk from the real deal, and here's what you got to do. And he said he hit every correct button there is in terms of the realities of life in this country and for these young people.
Well, he talked about also how to select the proper friends who are really in your corner, not because they're dreaming of dollar signs, just to get close to you. And I thought that bit he did with the basketball, when he asked for the basketball and he started kissing it and hugging it and telling all the youngsters, get high on this, baby. This is what the world's about for you young people. You don't need an artificial high.
coaches for the West. That's Louis Renault on the right, and his assistant coach Joel Hopkins. That's Joel Hopkins right there from Mount Zion Academy down in Durham, North Carolina.
He had at least 8 Division I prospects, they say, on his club down there at Mount Zion. As you look at De La Salle, they got a great football program down there as well. And he coached the Barry brothers, John, and also Drew Barry played for him in high school down in Concord, California. Got some special people here tonight, too. We got a group that, first of all, we got this family, the Van Basileer family. They donated Christian's Year $1,750 to the J.P. McCarthy Foundation. And I thought that was phenomenal. J.P., a legend here out in the Detroit area, who lost his life too early to the battle with cancer. And they donated $1,750 to sit near us at courtside and to share a moment with us at the banquet last night. And really happy for that. And then we got the honorary coach, Dan Fagan, from out of New York City. He's honorary coach, second year in a row. Just a great guy. They say he's got a great, great handle. I know he's got a beautiful smile, but I don't know about his jump shot.
Remains to be seen, right? And Dick Vitale back in those old stomping grounds, many years as the coach of the University of Detroit, as well as his run with the Pistons. How'd it feel to be back and talk to the folks last night?
Well, meeting a lot of people, former players and people that I know. It's always great coming here. The fans here are great sports fans, whether it be following the Tigers, the Pistons, the Red Wings, or the Lions. They really support their programs.
And we are ready for action.
Man-to-man defense, and we'll see no zones. We'll see a lot of running, transition, a lot of layups. You don't usually see great defense after about the first 3 minutes.
Not at all. Gray's inside, loses it for the East.
He's a big-time scorer. He's going out to Penn State. He's an alternate. Tony Harris was supposed to play but had an injury. He's going to Tennessee.
Short pop by Griffin, no good. Rebounded by Davis. Here comes the West in a hurry. Johnson ahead of the pack. And the next Keith Van Horn, they hope, gets rejected. Here comes the East back the other way.
Rick Majerus is happy with Johnson's decision to wear a Utah uniform.
There's McLean out top. Eli McLean in the corner. He's the coach's son. All of these players come in with marvelous credentials. A lot of patience so far in this particular set.
Trying to show some patience offensively.
Grace, who was vacationing in Cancun when he got the call to join this game. Front rims that one. Bell's going to get an easy one.
He's a big-time scorer out of high school here in Michigan. He's from Flint Southwestern High School, going to Michigan State. I know Magic was smiling. We'll see a lot of layups. You'll see very little balance defensively in rotating to get back to stop the transitions. Here comes another layup.
Lorenzo Guest, leave it for Davis, and we'll see a lot of
I'll tell you, they're going to be excited up in the Hawkeye land with Ricky Davis.
Tyree Ricky Davis, a 6'8 guard, Dick.
He's really a big-time second guard. Tom Davis has got a good one there. Jess Settles comes back next year as well.
Saw a bunch of college coaches here earlier today. Charlie Spoonhour underneath. Johnson with the foul on Morris. Charlie Spoonhour, Bill Baino had the biggest smile in probably the entire palace.
Well, he feels like $1 million today with the decision by Odom to go to UNLV. Gary Williams is here. Terrence Morris is in the game, who he has. He's also after Mark Karcher. Bobby Kremitz, he's been all over the place. Perry Clark, right to my right here is Clem Haskins sitting here to my right. Clem the Gem, coach of the year nationally. We got Baino sitting to my right, smiling like $1 million. But now the pressure's going to be on Baino to win, baby.
He knows it too. Morris, 1 out of 2.
They expected him to step in that lineup down in Maryland. They lose Keith Booth, who had a sensational year, but they return guys like Profit and Stokes.
Johnson in trouble, leaves it off to Davis. Can't get that one to McLean with a strong rebound. Sergio McLean.
Very physical. Look at his body. Very powerful player.
6'4", 210. Baseline. He's cut off down there.
He's being checked by Lorenzo Guest. He's going to Michigan State. Also a football player.
Bell with a nice lead. Runner, nothing going on there. And it'll stay West ball. The officials for today's game, Rich Sortino, Gene Manji, and Murph Shapiro. Let's look at Gene. Here's Davis.
Swinging the ball, sideline.
Broner trying to create some contact. Nothing doing there. Here comes the East back the other way. Graves had it knocked away. Johnson with one man to beat. Johnson attacking and let him have it.
Johnson to the goal. Gutierrez going to like him stepping in their lineup. They got a lot of good people returning. They lose Van Horn, who I certainly believe is one of our super six for the NBA draft. Some say right behind Tim Duncan. I mean, that's Lock City, who's number one, Dave.
No question. Folks in Boston saying their prayers every day. Try for the alley-oop. Nothing doing there for Melvin Eli, Adam Harvey, Illinois.
Well, Melvin Eli, a real slam-jam-bam guy, a shot blocker going out to Fresno State, where they've had a great recruiting class. And Kenny Bruner is also in the game, joining Eli. Bruner from out of California.
Out of Dominguez High School, Bruner picks up the foul, his first.
Well, they got a kid that's playing right now down there, a junior named Prince, who's tremendous down at Dominguez.
Melvin Eli, 6'10 center. Harvey, Illinois, went to Thornton High School, 18 points and 11 boards per game.
They got Winfrey Walton last year, rated by Bob Gibbons, number four in America, sitting the year out, was going to go to Syracuse, and is now down there with Jerry Tark at Fresno State.
Double block on that one for Johnson. Bruner, boy, I tell you what, he's going in hard, but getting a lot of shots sent back.
Well, that's Melvin Eli on the inside. He's a rejector. He's a real outstanding shot blocker.
Here's Johnson going inside, and a couple of people got a piece of that one.
There's Eli now with the block, and also a piece by Griffin as well.
Johnson, ice up and under, and it's sent back again.
Eli again.
And another turnover, fifth turnover for the East squad.
I'll tell you, when you got rejectors inside like Morris and Eli blocking shots, in fact, Eli averaged 7 block shots a game. That's incredible.
That it is. Wayne McClain, coach of the East. Bruner tried to leave it off. Knocked out of bounds. It'll stay West ball.
Kenny Bruner with that good penetration. Chris Heron comes back at Fresno State. They should be dynamite next year. A lot of the recruiting gurus rate their class, one of the top three in America.
Bell with the left hand headed block. So the East getting a lot of action underneath. Try for the reverse is good. Davis with the score, Ricky Davis.
I really like Ricky Davis, very agile.
There we go with Melvin Eli attacking the rim hard.
Hey, he's a high jumper, he's a high riser, an elevator guy.
Fresno State well represented here in this Magic round ball game. It'll stay white ball. Four 10-minute quarters here, Dick. And 10 players per side, and each player is guaranteed 20 minutes of playing time, minimum.
Kids have a lot of fun, starting with the banquet, all the activities they have provided for them. And the fact that Magic makes himself available is such a special moment for many of these young people.
It was amazing at the banquet. When he walked into the room, I mean, you could hear the breath go out of a lot of these kids. Get to meet and see Magic Johnson up close. And you know what else is doing was great too? The way Magic, after the banquet for about an hour, took nothing but pictures with the families of the kids.
Yeah, he said, all the families, stay around and we'll take photos with all of you. Tomorrow I'll take pictures with all the kids. And he really spent a moment with all the moms and dads and friends.
Bruner again, boy, I tell you what. He's hanging tough with that, and Eli with a chance for a 7th point. Hello!
There goes Eli with another jam. See, again, we see the example of very little rotation defensively. Balance is something that coaches work on diligently at practice sessions. Pretty tough to get him to do that here in one practice.
Tie ball game at 8 apiece. Davis along the baseline, got up and under.
Ricky Davis, a big-time prospect. He is going to be one heck of a player.
I thought it was interesting. A lot of people talked about the fact that he could be a Julius Erving type of player. We've got another turnover here. Bruner going to set up
nicely down to Ricky Davis.
Ricky Davis got a great guard joining him as well. Remember this name, Dean Oliver. They think he's going to be special and step in for Andre Woolridge. I think Tom Davis's club could be a real sleeper club in the Big Ten next year.
Right now, Melvin Eli.
Eli says, hey, who said I just blocked shots?
Tell you what, that's 7 blocks a game, 18 points and 11 boards.
I'll tell you, Dave, you look at the stats of these players.
Isn't it scary?
It's amazing.
7 blocks in a game? Come on, even I don't care what level that is. You're talking big numbers. 4:18 to go, first period here at the Magic's Round Ball Classic. It's 12-10 for the West. We return after these messages. Welcome back, everybody, to the Magic's Round Ball Classic. West with the lead, 12-10, and pretty good highlight here. One of your Dunkaroos specials, Dick Vitale.
Well, there's the up and up and away jam, reverse jam by Ricky Davis. What a player he's going to be out there for Dr. Tom Davis, who did a great job this year with a club that a lot of people thought would struggle when they lost. They lost Jess Settles.
Yeah.
Now, if Settles comes back healthy, and I certainly wish him nothing but the best and like to see him back in that uniform up at Iowa, they're going to have a nice, nice mixture. I was looking at a stat that really amazes me as we look at Ricky Davis here. Look at those numbers. Wow. But Bob Gibbons did a report about the fact of 100 top players, 85 signed early. And that's a lot more than in the past. Seems like more and more kids, as he said in his report, were getting really ready for the test score.
There's Guess. He misses along the baseline. Davis with the putback is good. So Ricky Davis.
Nice touch. Nice stroke as well.
He's got 10 points.
He's got a proud dad and mom. Met him last night. And I could see why they're excited.
McLean has got an absolute football body. It's amazing that he has not been recruited heavily in the football scene. Broner to Davis. Layup for Ricky Davis. He's got 12.
Ricky Davis putting a show on here early. I'll tell you one thing, Dr. Tom Davis, you got a diaper dandy, baby.
Turnover story. West hasn't turned it over yet. Eli. And he's looking good too, Dick.
I'll tell you, Melvin Eli and Ricky Davis, the early stars here. Hey, statistics almost become meaningless here. We look at all those stats and we really wonder at times in a game like this, it's up and up and down.
Graves underneath and he scores. Greg Graves out of Southfield, Michigan, Lathrop High School.
Yeah, he came out of Lathrop High School last year. The Alton Air player ended up getting the MVP. Kid named Phillips, Rashard Phillips at Detroit. We're playing for Kerry Watson next year.
That knocked out of bounds. It'll stay West ball. Pretty good crowd on hand here at the Palace at Auburn Hills. See another wave of players in another few minutes. Underneath, Davis. Davis is getting everything he wants and more along the baseline.
He just got that nose for scoring. And the thing I like about him, he moves well without the ball. As we all know, that's one of the lost arts for a lot of kids, learning how to move without the ball.
Amen. Magic Johnson, look forward to having him over here when he talks to us. And there was a point he brought up last night about when he played an all-star game, everybody was dunking. Then he said the opening tap, he says, now it's time to play ball.
Yeah, he shared that at halftime. I did an interview with Magic and with Sonny Vaccaro, and he shared that story. There's a look at a guy that won four state championships in a row. Wow.
Knocked away.
Peoria Manual High School, number one in the USA Today poll.
Britton Johnson to Kenny Broner. Kenny Broner going to get a roll. It's blocked by number 12, Marcus Griffin. Bell right back. Nothing doing there. Johnson rebounds. Johnson, no.
I'll tell you, Griffin's a tough inside player. Good, strong interior player.
Bell, he's short. Kept alive, and Griffin. Here comes the East.
Terrence Morris wanted a lob.
A little strong there. And then Eli gets another bucket. Melvin Eli's got 13.
Well, I'll tell you, it's a shootout right now between Eli and Davis. Hey, Maryland's going to be really good because of watching Terrence Morris. He's going to be a big-time performer right out of the gate.
All right, Britton Johnson stepping outside to stroke the long one.
Yeah, showing that versatility. You mentioned the name Van Horn, who was so versatile for Utah. And Rick Majerus really high on Johnson.
Cuts off the baseline there. We get a foul on Kenny Broner.
I'll tell you how high Majerus is on Johnson. I'm in the lobby talking to Billy Packer and Rick Majerus. We're at the hotel at the Final Four. And the first thing Rick wanted to know, hey, anybody see the McDonald's game? Did you see my kid Johnson? Did he play great? Well, Billy said, yeah, he played fire. He did okay. He said, no, come on. Was he great? Was he super? I mean, Rick's really excited about Johnson wearing a uniform.
Holding a play right now, asking Johnson to tuck his uniform in. Anything you'd say about Johnson, just needs to get a little bit bigger and stronger. Reverse attempt, nothing doing.
Well, most of these kids,
yeah,
that's a problem. You can Tracy McGrady going to the NBA, and that's another thing I agree with Billy Packer about, the fact that, number one, we hear the NBA execs say, we want these kids to go to school. I really wonder. I agree with Billy that I think they almost encourage all these kids to come out to get more people in the pool. When you're flashing the kind of dollars they're flashing,
Yes, and he scores despite the block attempt by Sergio McClain. Finish that point, Dick.
Well, you know, you're flashing all that green. It's sometimes very tough for a young man to be able to say no. And I really think that the NBA's got to get together with the NCAA and come up with a solution and a plan, maybe adopt one like baseball utilizes, where once you step on a college campus, you're not eligible to be drafted until after your third year. They say legally it won't work. Well, how come it works in baseball?
Talked to David Stern, the NBA commissioner, at a forum at Madison Square Garden the other day, and he said, personally, he's not in favor of these youngsters coming out, but he says, hey, how can you begrudge somebody going after a pot of gold that they put right in front of you?
Well, that's the point I made last night. Don't blame the kids. Many of us, if somebody at 18 is watching another layup, if somebody puts $1 million plus in front of you and says, we'll give you on-the-job training while you're 18 and 19 if you don't go to college, you know, many of us would have taken it. You know that, and I know that.
Eli with the block along the baseline. It's West leading 23-18. Dave Sims and Dick Vitale with you from the Palace at Auburn Hills.
We won't be talking a lot of strategy here. We'll be talking a lot of philosophy, a lot of theories, and have a lot of fun with everybody else. It's been a fun situation. I got a kick watching the coaches in the lobby last night. I was teasing Cremins and Gary Clark. I said, am I glad I'm not coaching again? You're watching them with the bumps and with the looks and making sure that the players see that they're there. Wow. Nothing more degrading than Jason is 17 year older and he's got his entourage and you got to tell him he's the greatest thing in the world because he's got your paycheck right in his teeth. With every bite he's got, he controls your destiny.
And he's telling 12 other kids the same thing. Then you got to put them together, right?
Yeah.
You've been there. Sergio McClain working against Lorenzo Guess.
Lorenzo Guess, a football player, great quarterback, and played quarterback up at Michigan State. I was teasing him. I said, forget the helmet. Stay in basketball.
That longevity. 32.4 seconds to go in the first quarter. 25-18 West over the East. Guess leaves it for Griffin, and a foul. Foul beforehand.
You know, that's an amazing stat when we think about it. Winning four state championships.
That's incredible.
In Illinois, where competition is so strong. I mean, that is just, they should feel so proud at Peoria Emanuel. That city produces a lot of players. As we look at the contact and the drive on the baseline, and here's one of the reasons that they're won those titles. Marcus Griffin almost went to Indiana along with McClain, and last second they decided to join Lon Kruger. And what I thought was a key recruiting success for Kruger, coming in as a new coach.
Yes, indeed.
Develop a little identity as a recruiter.
Did a good job getting the two kids from Manuel. He's got McClain and this young man, Griffin. Marcus was the MVP at the Adidas Big Time Tournament.
He also went out and got a kid, Corey Bradford, from out of Memphis.
Little press.
Zone press. He's going to beat it with dribble penetration.
Griffin with a late bump there.
You know, Dave, what really excites me about a lot of young kids and about college basketball is the arrival of the Diaper Dandies on the collegiate scene. We talk about players leaving, but it excites me always looking for the new kids on a block. This year, Michael Bibby. What a job he did with Arizona as we watch Bruner slashing down the lane.
Bruner with a good-looking bucket, and that's a point well made, too, because a lot of people were saying that, hey, the college game was going to suffer with all the kids that left last year. The game always rejuvenates itself.
It really does. Dave Gavitt said it best. When Dave Gavitt, the father of the Big East, he said at a Clear B function that I was at with Billy Packer, he said, hey, the college game is about the name on the front jersey. The NBA is about the name on the back jersey.
There you go. Eli with the steal almost scored it at the buzzer. So at the end of 10 minutes, first quarter, it's the West leading the East 27-20. We'll see a whole new group of kids in the second quarter. And we'll go to break with the West leading 27-20 here at Auburn Hills. Welcome back, everybody, to the home court of the Detroit Pistons. We're here for Magic's Round Ball Classic. It's the West leading 27-20. Dave Sims and Dick Vitale with you. A whole bunch of college coaches on hand to watch some of this outstanding high school talent. And here's a look at one of the final plays of that first period. Lorenzo Guess going up, and McClain got a piece of it, but the ball went in nonetheless.
That's that football toughness that Lorenzo has from Wayne, Michigan. Tracy McGrady now going to throw the ball in bounds here from out of that Mount Zion Academy down there at Christian Academy in Durham, North Carolina.
Here's a look at the players on the floor right now. This is a good matchup. Lamar Odom going against McGrady.
And some people rated them 1-2 in the country.
There's Chris Burgess, cross court to McGrady. He's going to fire one up. And Karcher runs down the rebound for the East. El Amin. First shot, no good. Gets a chance to run it down.
Elamine still available. Georgetown, Minnesota. They say maybe Connecticut and Kansas.
Odom's pass to Anthony. And here's the save back to Odom. Mara Odom with the lefty. Can't get it. Putback is good. And he said he likes the game of Tracy Augment. You can see that. He's big, tall, rangy left-hander.
I'll tell you one thing. He's got explosiveness, very agile. I know after the camps last year, Bob Gibbons rated him number one in the country in the summer.
Long shot off the backboard by...
Oh, what a great handoff.
Sure was. Karcher, nothing doing there.
What a great look with that bounce pass.
Karcher, he's short, and here comes the West. Daniels taken away by Elamine. Nice play.
Elamine so strong physically.
Got a little bit too much.
He had committed verbally to Minnesota, then changed his mind. Got some people up there a little upset.
And there's a guy that's going to make Coach K and the Dukies happy, Chris Burgess.
Well, not only Mr. Burgess, but Elton Brand, our big power inside player, and Shane Battier, who's from Michigan, Mr. Basketball. You're only allowed to play in two games, and if a kid plays in the Capital Classic at the McDonald's, he can't play this game, and that's what Shane Battier has done from Detroit Country Day. See, the one thing Duke didn't have last year, Dave, was post presence inside. They were perimeter-oriented. Now they're going to have that presence.
You look for them to be the immediate favorite with these three kids coming in, the immediate favorite in the ACC?
Well, you know, in the ACC, you got to give a slight edge, but nationally, you still got to give that edge to Arizona if they won't return.
West with the ball, leading 29-24.
Talent amazes me. Every year, they get more agile, stronger physically. It's just unbelievable the talent that's out there.
Burgess gets it back to McGrady. McGrady, a little baseline pull-up is good.
And a good middle range jump shot. Ball skills. Really captivated everybody at the ABCD camp, but he's got to play on the defensive end.
Ball tipped up and still alive. East comes down with it. Glover gets down on the floor, but it's going to stay.
Deion Glover's ball. Great guy. I was teasing Bobby Cribbage yesterday. So I went to church with Bobby at the banquet. I thought the place went nuts when I said that. I said, I went to church with Bobby Cribbage, and he was lighting a candle, and I was behind him as we watched the loose ball and Glover diving, and I heard him mumbling. He said, God, please let me get Deion. Let me get him at Georgia Tech. And God said back to him, said, hey, Bobby, what can I tell you? Tubby Smith was here a week earlier.
Deion Glover out of Decatur, Georgia. Number four on the floor.
Looks like it'll be the Georgia Tech for Glover.
McGrady finds Cutter Daniels, and he's able to lay it up and in.
Nice look.
Edwin Greedy Daniels.
He's got a brother, they tell me, that's tremendous. A brother will be a rising senior next year in high school. Daniels, a tough defensive player.
Oh, nice spin. Elamine. Oh, my goodness.
Elamine.
Oh.
Showtime.
He roasted Greedy Daniels.
And Clem Haskins sitting to my right looked and said, it looked nice in the uniform with us. Winning.
Glover right back. Man on the wing had been running. Maybe he could have caught that. Myron Anthony from Khalid El Amin. Take a timeout. West leading 35-26, 6:52 to go, second quarter in Magic's Round Ball Classic. Have you back with us here at Auburn Hills, and take a look at Edwin Greedy Daniels on this one, Dick.
Yeah, he's really a good, outstanding point guard. There he is with the catch and the conversion. Daniels, he's going out to UNLV, where he'll join the likes of Mr. Odom. As you're watching Elamine now, a little showtime. He brought Clem Haskins out of his seat, sitting to my right. Clem sent a message. I said, Clem, are you going to get him during the break? He said, I hope so. But John Thompson and Roy Williams and Jim Calhoun are after him as well. All great recruiters.
Burgess, little face up short. Odom with the rebound. East breaks, 4-on-3. Oh, nice finish. Nice, strong finish by Edmund Saunders.
Saunders going out to Connecticut. Outstanding player. Big guy. He'll be joining that UConn team. Had a lot of good young players this year with Bosco, certainly Freeman, and really development of Richie Hamilton, who averaged 26 a game in the 5 NIT games. I think he's going to be a star in the Big East.
Bright young team, the Connecticut Huskies. Glover, a little leaner in the lane. Deion Glover.
He's very strong, physically Glover. Played at Cedar Grove High School out of Decatur, Georgia.
El Amin, little guy, showing you something, getting in the lane.
I'll tell you, he's a penetrator, he's a slasher. I was impressed watching him last year over at the ABC camp, the one day that I saw him, he played well. Look how strong he is. He's like a running back. He looks like a running back. He wants the ball, pigskin. He looks like a little Barry Sanders.
That's right.
Hey, we're in Detroit. Looks like Barry Sanders.
Silver Dome right around the corner here. 5'11 point guard out of North High School in Minneapolis. Won back-to-back state titles, Gatorade Player of the Year. Like everybody here, strong, strong credentials.
They all do. They have great resumes when you look at all these people. They really do. You look at, we talked about Saunders going out to UConn, where they got so many good young players. El Amin, there is a look at him right here, strong physically. The kids are getting stronger. I think it's the weight program.
No question.
It's the unbelievable specialization that takes place.
Years ago, you never talked about weightlifting except for football. Now you got the baseball players big as ever. The basketball players are cut and defined. Long jumper, a little short there, run down by Saunders. Gonna leave it for Karcher. And Greedy Daniels with three men.
You see Daniels make the play.
McGrady
with the Tomahawk jam. He's got to work a little bit harder on the defensive end and put a little bit more effort on that defensive end. But offensively, he's got a lot of skills. He's got to get physically a lot stronger.
I mean,
I like Odom's passing ability. That's what's impressed me early. Watching the way he passes the basketball.
He's like 6'10 now. He's grown like crazy the last few years. Anthony underneath, Burgess challenged that one, and McGrady rebound.
Nice look by Odom inside to Anthony, going out to Kentucky. Nice look.
Glover, Burgess is there, puts it home. Chris Burgess on the follow. West leading 41-30. Well, see, for Burgess, he's got four.
Burgess is gonna help out guys like Trajan Langdon and Wojciechowski and certainly Ricky Price and McLeod. They got a lot of good perimeter players. They just need some post presence. Down at Duke.
Burgess, big block. A foul before. Came from the weak side.
Yeah, Burgess rotating over. Give up, gave some help.
Foul on Byron
Wilton. Wotan with the foul.
His first team second.
Burgess going to rotate over from the help side. There he is, gets the good angle. So important in blocking shots, getting good angles. That's really the key to all great shot blockers. Anthony going out to Kentucky. We're also got Ryan Hogan, outstanding shooter from Deerfield, Illinois. And then they got the kid at the last second, Michael Bradley, who they got because of the fact of the Boston College absolute mess, where Bradley had really declared that he wanted to go to Boston College verbally as a junior. But then when he saw what happened to his guys, DePina and Elton Tyler, he said, I'm out of here. They rejected his buddies.
And that's why Jimmy O'Brien is at Ohio State now. Oh, a lot of activity on the west. A lot of activity. McGrady with the tip. He's got four. Anthony going to challenge. Moten got up and got the ball, but also fouled Myron Anthony.
Luton's a guy that right now is open. Told me it's either Kentucky, Tulane, or Arkansas. As you watch Luton rotating over. There's the contact from out of Louisiana.
Rain, Louisiana, his second foul.
So you look at Kentucky, and they add Hogan, they add Anthony and Bradley at 6'11", and then sitting out, Jeff Shepard, along with also a kid transferred who I know you saw play out of Manhattan, Hishamu Evans, who's a pretty good player. They got some good players going to join their cast that's returning.
You're going to like Hishamu Evans, slasher, left-handed kid, about 6'6".
Yeah, very active, will be very active and impressive for Coutinho. But what they lack is they need that one difference maker. The one guy that I call them, the guy that really takes you to that next level, like they've had with the Ron Mercy.
How about Burgess from about 28 feet?
Can't be serious with that one. Mike Krzyzewski saying, no way, Chris. Don't get ideas to shoot that. There's Glover with that strong body. You can see why Tommy Smith's here today. Bobby Fremont's here. They didn't come to see you, Dave.
Not at all.
They didn't come to see me.
Timeout called by the East squad, and for good reason. The West pouring it on, leading 48-34 with 3:49 to go. Second quarter from the Palace at Auburn Hills. This is Magic's Round Ball Classic. Take a look at the range of Chris Burgess. Who said big guys can't shoot from long range, Dick Vitale? Look at this.
Well, I'll tell you one thing. Watch this range right here. We're not serious. I mean, that's way behind the NBA line. I mean, that is trifecta from downtown. He shot that, I mean, from Flint, Michigan.
I'm telling you.
Incredible.
Alamine, a little change of pace off the glass and in.
Alamine's one of those, what I call, not a point guard, a lead guard. He's got great scoring ability.
He's got 6 points. West in control here, 48-36, Greedy Daniels.
You know, Daniels going out to UNLV, sitting out for them last year was Isaiah Epps, and also a kid named Kevin Simmons. They'll join Keon Clark. I mean, they're going to have one heck of a lineup.
Odom loses it, Greedy Daniels to Glover. That works. I think the crowd like that one.
As Glover's throwing it up on the glass. Greedy finishes it off.
Greedy with eight. Odom had turned it over last trip for Saunders.
Lamar Odom assisting
Jay. Saunders with his fourth point.
I think Saunders with the score, but again, Odom an outstanding passer.
If had he gone to Kentucky, would that have really completed the package? You're talking about all the people they have coming back, the transfers in. Burgess got hit, thought he was going to get a foul. And
should have got a foul. No call right there. He got really mugged on the inside.
El Amin.
Nice play.
Nice flush by Saunders.
Saunders running the court, but a great decision by El Amin. Good little bounce pass. Plays hard. I like Archer. El Amin plays really hard.
No doubt about it. And he's a guy, instant kind of credibility to your backcourt.
Yeah, he'll really help. There's no question. I think most of these guys that you're looking at right here are going to get instant PT wherever they go.
Boy, El Amin stepping out, in and out. Can he run it down? No. And it'll stay at this end of the floor. El Amin, 24 points, 6 rebounds, 6 steals, and shot 58% from the field. Ouch.
I can see that because I'm getting, he gets a lot of layups in transition, a lot of drives to the basket.
Saunders can't knock that one down. And Greedy Daniels breaks back the other way. Daniels sets up for the layup. Well done. Mouton from Rain, Louisiana.
Mouton, a very explosive player. His cousin plays Major League Baseball for the Chicago White Sox. A great guy, too. Lyle Mouton, who wants to get into broadcasting, he told me. I was watching him at the batting cage along with Albert Bell and Frank Thomas one day down in Sarasota, Florida. Just a great guy. Went to LSU, played some basketball down there for Dale Brown.
And was drafted originally by the Yankees. Odom inside, couldn't get it up in the air, thought he was fouled.
They're letting him play, a lot of physical contact.
The way the kids want it. Burgess, try not to get too frustrated. I saw him yesterday at practice a couple of times. These two squads scrimmaged for about 5 minutes, and a couple of times he had his guy locked down on the box and couldn't get the ball. And a couple of coaches said, relax, this is what happens at All-Star games. Get your rebounds and hang tough.
Yeah,
he was really getting frustrated.
It becomes a guard-oriented situation at All-Star games, and certainly the perimeter players usually dominate statistically because they don't wait for the big guys to get inside and to post.
He's got a little guy right now, McGrady fires up and scores. Hit a three.
Tracy McGrady showing that he's got inside-outside ability.
He's got 11 points today.
Outstanding high school team down here at Mount Zion.
El Amin. El Amin.
I'll tell you, it's that showtime. Clint the Jim Haskins smiling like you can't believe the National Coach of the Year. He's smiling, saying he can make me even smile a little better if he says Minnesota.
Glover with the follow.
Glover certainly the talent out in Georgia. Another great kid out there by the name of Jermaine Jones will be going out to the University of Georgia playing for Tubby Smith. Glover has not made his decision yet. Georgia Tech, Georgia, maybe an outside shot, Tulane. There's a look at McLean, coaching on the sideline. Coach McLean, Peoria Emanuel.
Three-point play for Glover. 58-44. Final 20 seconds. Anthony with the pull-up. Short. Overtime rebound.
Anthony had a solid year this year on a high school level in the state of Florida.
Daniels, left hand, got it up and in.
Greedy Daniels with that little layup. Yes, sir.
Chris Burgess lets her rip at the buzzer. Oh, boy, he had a great chance. Nice job by Chris Burgess.
Just what we expected, Dave. A lot of up and down, a lot of transition, a lot of dunking, a lot of layups, and very little defense. A lot of matador defense, but really a great job of showcasing a lot of the agility and mobility of the future stars of the collegiate level.
Coming up at halftime, Dick's interview with Sonny Vaccaro and Magic Johnson coming your way from the Palace at Auburn Hills. Welcome back, everybody. The West dominating so far here in the Magic Round Ball Classic, 60-44. Our score here at halftime. Dave Sims and Dick Vitale. And Dick, as all-star games go, is this going pretty much according to script, or have you seen anything that maybe some differences here?
Not really going according to script. You know, up and down tempo, fast-paced game, a lot of slam dunks, a lot of transition, and very little inside play.
That's right.
Why the post guy, you say, Burgess gets a little upset. He's locking on a box inside, like I'm locking right here on you. There's no rock coming inside, baby.
Right. He was killing people down the post. Could not get the ball. Who's jumped out at you so far? I know certainly McClain played well early. Melvin Eli got off very early for the East with a bunch of points.
I'll tell you, I was impressed early out of the gate with Ricky Davis. He's as good as advertised going out to Iowa. Certainly Melvin Eli blocking shots on the inside. And I love the passing ability and just the court finesse of Lamar Odom. I mean, he hasn't scored big, but you could just see that he has all that poise. Khalid El-Amin showing a lot of strength and a good body, and so does Deion Glover, very strong physically.
It's our halftime festivities continuing here from the Palace at Auburn Hills. Dick had a chance to sit down with Sonny Vaccaro, as well as the Magic man himself, as we look at Grant Hill in attendance here at his home court to watch Magic's Round Ball Classic, some of the best high school talent in the country. And we'll continue from the Palace right after these words. Back here at Auburn Hills, it's the West leading 60-44 here at halftime. And Dick Vitale earlier today sat down with the director of Magic's Round Ball Classic, Sonny Vaccaro, as well as Magic Johnson himself. And here's a look at that interview.
On my left, he doesn't need an introduction, with one of the greatest players ever to play the game, Irvin Magic Johnson. Next to Irvin, the founder of the game, Sonny Vaccaro. First thing I want to ask, Irvin, how does a guy like yourself, I know you're so busy in terms of the financial world and also busy in the corporate world, how do you find time to give your name, and what really prompted you to give your name to a game like this and be involved? Because you don't just give your name, you're here.
Right.
Did a great job speaking last night.
Well, thank you, and you did too. And we're the same. We're all three of us. We're all about the kids. And the reason I lent my name and the reason I'm involved is because this gentleman right here, Sonny, because he gives his heart and soul. And normally, it's a lot of all-star games, but nobody cares more about these kids than the three of us. We care about them on the court. We care about them off the court. And because of Sonny's leadership and because of his ability to want to groom these guys. Forget the basketball side of it. They're going to take care of that. You know, he wants to see them grow as men, into men. He wants to see them when they're 10, 15 years down the line. Like he was just saying, I said, where's Albert King? He told me where Albert King was, you know. He can tell me where Kenny Fields is and so on. And I mean, this guy cares about these guys more than they would ever know. If they never, ever, something happened this summer where one of them broke their legs and they couldn't play ever again, this guy would still be calling them, hey, you know, champ, hey, maybe I got a job for you. Maybe let me help you. Everything's all right. And that's what I'm about too. And that's why I gave all of them my number and said, look, you need me, I'm there for you. Tracy, who's coming out, I said, okay. I work with everybody that ever—
Tracy McGrady.
Yes, who's ever came out of college. I said, I worked with Shaquille before he went. I went, Anthony Hardaway spent 2 weeks with me before he was into the NBA. I said, so I work with all these guys. I said, okay, here's my number. You come out and I'll work with you. And so I love them. I love these young men.
No doubt about it. You did a great job last night at the banquet. Sonny, he mentioned Albert King. Tell him a story about how Albert and Gene Banks were the two guys instead of him for the Dapper Dan.
Why do I got to go through that? This is documented. I picked Albert and Gene because at that time the world acknowledged them, all the writers and everybody. They were the best. This little kid here was an afterthought. And, you know, I'm part of that. And I understood, and I said, well, I got to get the names. I got to get Wayne McCoy was another name. I got to get the names. Irvin was like a sub-name. You know, if I didn't get a couple of other names, I was bringing Irvin up. Well, one thing, my man said, no, I'll come up on my terms. You pass me the first time, I'm going here and play. I lost. But you know what? It makes a better story. It makes a better story now because I made a mistake, and he proved that you don't have to be number one going in. it's number one when it's over, and there's no question about that.
Hey, Sonny, I thought it was great last night at the banquet, Irvin, when you told those youngsters, when you were oohing and ahhing, when Albert was dunking and Banks was dunking at the McDonald's All-American game, and you were there saying, oh, I'm nervous. Share that with the people.
Well, what happened was, you know, that we were in layup line, and they were doing some tremendous dunks. As you know, Albert King could jump out the gym, so he was a dunker. Boom, boom. Albert, Gene Banks, bam. Wayne McCoy, way older, bam. And so all the other guys, bam, bam. Now here I am laying it up. And all the crowd going, woo, woo, woo. This little kid from Lansing, he lays it up. Everybody like, hey. So we go through. So now the ball goes up.
Now it's time to play basketball.
Now it's time to play.
That's what you can do well.
That's what I could do. So the ball went up, and I was in my element then.
he took over.
Then I was the ooh and ah man.
Yeah, he was ooh and ah over here for years. Sonny, where does the money, basically, the profits from a game like this, where do they go? Tell the people.
Every penny that goes to the boys' clubs and the AIDS hospice here in Detroit. We keep the money in Detroit, and that's from day one, it stayed here. And it's been very nice for both charities since day one.
That's really fantastic. Fantastic. And also some great news learning about the HIV virus. Certainly he still has that dilemma to deal with, but he's doing a phenomenal job, and it's so positive. We wish you nothing but the best, Irvin.
Thanks. Thank you. God has been good. Blessed us all. This has been a blessing just to be here, to be a part of this. Thank you. Thank Sonny. And I know he's whining. You know that circle said that's it. So you better close it real quick.
Well, like, to anybody that missed the banquet last night, this guy here was unbelievable. He took the basketball, he kissed it, and he told the youngsters, get high on this, baby. Get high. When I look at this, I get high on this. You don't need an artificial high. A genuine superstar in every aspect of life, Irvin Magic Johnson. And Magic's Round Ball Classic is what it is because of Sonny Vaccaro.
Yep. Nice job.
Score the West leading, and we'll continue with a look at the halftime stats and get the second half underway in a couple of moments here on the Deuce. Have a look at halftime numbers here in the Magic Round Ball Classic. West leading 60-44 here at the Palace at Auburn Hills. With the second half coming your way in a couple of seconds. The numbers from the first half. The West shot 48%, but they did it by going 27-56 compared to 17-34 for the East ball club. 3 points shooting, not a real big factor. Free throws, the East doing pretty well there. Rebounds, it's an edge for the East, but look at the turnovers. 4 turnovers for the West, 16 for the East. And that is a big, big number for this first half of this game. The West with 16 assists and 4 turnovers. The East with 8 assists and 16 turnovers. 60-44 is the halftime score. West over the East. Magic's Round Ball Classic. Some of the best players in high school basketball for 1996-97. Second half action is forthcoming here on the Deuce from Auburn Hills. to 44, halftime score. West leading the East here in Magic's Round Ball Classic. Dave Sims and Dick Vitale with you as we take a look at some of the halftime highlights, the first half highlights. And tell you what, the athleticism is abundant here today. There's no question about it.
I'll tell you, that's what makes a lot of these players, their up and down ability. The area they have to work on is the fundamentals of the game. Working a little bit more on making that good pass, learning how to understand to square your body, shoot the jumper. Everybody wants to emulate the likes of Michael Jordan and Sean Kemp and fly through the sky, and that's what Magic addressed last night. You know, all you guys want to be slam dunkers because of the guys you're watching on the NBA level. Be your own guy. He said, hey, once they throw the ball up, you don't play it above the rim. You play it down below. And he said, once the game started, I knew I was in command. He said, I couldn't dunk.
That's it. Tracy McGrady, this from Edwin Greedy Daniels.
Yeah, McGrady went 5-for-5 in the first half. Played really well. I thought Ricky Davis was sensational at 7-8.
Here's Myron Anthony working down low. He stayed with it.
Fletcher High School down there in Jacksonville, Florida, going out to Kentucky. Will be a member of the Wildcats. What about Ricky P saying no to the Boston Celtics?
And here's Glover.
Glover going to lay it on the glass, going to throw the assist up. And there's the jam on a reverse by Tracy McGrady.
There's Magic Johnson.
I was teasing Magic. So, Magic, you got to change one thing about this game. Make sure you got to play in the game. You got to play in the game with those kids. Wow, watching him going up and down the floor. I think what he said he'd like to do, if it was legal, he's going to check, I guess, with the NCAA, is the night before bring in his Magic Johnson All-Stars and play against these kids with all the money going to charity.
That would be great. That would be outstanding. There's a look at your leading scorers. Davis and McGrady leading the West Club, and Eli and El Amin, who came off the bench with 8 points.
Melvin Eli had to make Danny Tarkanian, Jerry's son, who's here today. Jerry a little bit under the weather with a cold, they said, and not being able to be out here. He's got all that controversy to deal with down at Fresno State. Seems like Jerry, year in and year out, there's always seems to be a controversy that surrounds his situation. And let's hope and pray there's nothing to it about players working in terms of with gamblers fixing games. We don't need that kind of mess in college basketball.
Not at all. And this half, Magic will sit on the West bench. And Wayne McClain, the East coach.
Yeah.
In his 12th year at Manual High School in Peoria, Illinois. There's a look at Clem Haskins. Fabulous year in Minnesota Golden Gophers, Coach of the Year.
Yeah, I did a tremendous job. I almost got a job as an assistant, but he doesn't want to pay me enough to go there.
Well, what was your price for crying out loud?
The price was a little high when I went to him, wasn't it?
Here's Griffin, knocked away.
What I like about Clem, he's a great father, a great family man.
And he'll takes it all the way. Take that bell, Charlie Bell. And Eli.
Eli likes
off again.
He said, I like this no defense. I like these automatic jams that I'm getting.
Renzo Guest, quick White. Pop, front rim. Sure did. Sergio McClain.
Charlie Bell's going to be a slasher. Going to hook up in the backcourt with Mateen Cleaves down at Michigan State.
Good looking jump shot.
That's Greg Graves. Interesting story. Alternate came from Cancun, was there on a vacation when he got the word that he was going to be able to play. His grandmother sent him there for the great year he had. And he's also a solid student academically going to Penn State.
Makes the steal. Almost a spectacular play. Griffin
averaged 32 points a game for Southfield Lathrop High School.
He's got 19 points. He had 15 in that first half. Bruner. Penetrates Johnson, kick, finish it, tipped up and in. Tipped up and in by Davis.
Dominguez is Kenny Bruner really past the rock.
Oh, no box out at all. Eli to foul on Johnson.
I think Eli wants to get that MVP trophy. He wants to go home with all the gold.
Third foul on Britton Johnson.
They were runner-ups. I guess that's a great honor knowing Peoria Manuel's in that state.
Sure is. Four straight state titles. Can you name off the top of your head other clubs that have done things like that?
No, I mean, that's incredible when you think about it. I mean, you can't get better than that. That's perfect. Number one in USA Today's poll as well. Here's Eli, showed his shot blocking ability at the ABCD camp this summer.
Likes to work with young people too. He's
what a class Jerry Tarkanian's got coming in. I mean, if you rate the classes, Bob Gibbons, who does an outstanding job with his report, had them rated in the top five in America, top three at Iowa State. What a class Tim Floyd's got coming in down at Iowa State with Marcus Pfizer and company. A kid by the name of Jared Henderson as well, both from Louisiana.
Brandon Johnson, nice pass. Scores it to Ricky Davis.
Ricky Davis again showing that ability we talked about in the first half. Movement without the basketball. Toughest player to guard.
18 points for Davis. Davis takes over for the West.
I think he's going to be a big star up in Iowa. I really believe he's going to be a special player.
Guest tipped it up. Couldn't get it. McClain back for the East. Right to the basket, and he missed the layup.
Oh, he went to the rack and came up empty.
66-52, Bell. Bruner inside. He's been inside all day. Boy, he's... Land of the Giants. Guest gets it up, gets the roll. Count it.
Lorenzo Guest from out of Wayne, Michigan High School. A QB. They say he's an outstanding football prospect, an All-American.
What? Second field goal for Guest on the afternoon.
Here he is in triple threat position, going to take the ball right down the gut of the defense. Gets a little help right here. Rich Sortino says, good, baby. Referees donate their time as well. Shapiro. Gene Monty. There's another look as he lays it on the glass.
It'll be East ball. Lorenzo Guess, a four-time all-conference performer at Wayne Memorial.
Some other classes that were really great this year, according to most of the experts. St. John's with Ron Artis. Artis coming in. That was a great commitment from Fran Fraschella. James Felton and company, they got to get point guard help. I know Shannon Crooks is their guy they're looking at.
Nice steal by Guess.
It's Guess with the jam.
Shannon Crooks is a young man from Canada.
No, he's a kid coming in, I believe, out of
Boston. He's the one out of the Boston area.
Yeah, Boston area.
I know they were looking at another young man from Toronto. Wayne.
You can play, they'll find you today.
No question.
But Texas has got a great class coming in. They got five guys over 6'8". North Carolina State, Herb Sendick's here. He's after Bouton as well. They're in a battle with Kentucky. His mentor, Rick Pitino's after him as well.
Fabulous job by Herb this year.
Oh, he's got a great class coming in next year. Miller and Kenny Hinge. Kid by the name of Kelly.
Braves for three.
Venus Williams.
Nice rebound by Guess. Takes over for the West.
And North Carolina and Wake Forest got solid classes.
Johnson, no on the three, and Gray's will run it down for the East.
Johnson's going to be an inside-outside player at Utah. Archer, Archer out big numbers out of St. Francis. He had verbally committed to Villanova and then pulled back on his commitment, and right now he's being recruited yet by Villanova. And certainly Maryland's involved with him heavily in Georgia Tech. This Garcher gets the contact, close to contact, goes to the line.
Garcher out of St. Francis in Baltimore, 6'5", 215.
Average about 30 a game, 29.6.
Eight boards, three steals, seven assists, and they did it on 63% shooting and 90% from the line.
You know, Tennessee's got a nice class with Harris and Story and a kid, an outstanding prep player, and a kid by the name of Baker. But you know what I really have a problem with? Coaches that leave go to other jobs, and then the youngsters who sign
locked in
being forced, as you watch little Jim Schott, my guest, being forced to honor their commitment and go to that school, and they lose his eligibility. I'd like to see, and I've said it time and time again, that rule change, that if a coach leaves or signs that youngster early, that youngster should be allowed to be re-recruited again by the new coach, and if he doesn't want to go there, he should be allowed to go elsewhere and not suffer a penalty.
That rule defies common sense.
Oh, it does, really, because most kids sign with their feeling and fitting that system with that coach.
And the personality of the coach.
And we're talking basically so people understand us. Not kids that are at the college. We're talking about high school players
that
have never enrolled yet on that college camp.
Britton Johnson taking a pounding inside. Ball knocked away, and here comes the East trailing 72-54.
Hey, Dave, you don't see too many five-on-fives, too many ball rotations from side to side. Swinging the ball, it's up and a down, it's Jam City. And there's another Ricky jam.
Ricky Davis.
Ricky. They're going to love him up in the air, sir, in Hawkeye land. Dr. Tom, you got a good one, baby.
20 points for Ricky Davis, 5:38 and counting, third quarter. And the West in command by 20. And that's good. Mark Karcher.
That's Karcher's ability. He's got the ability to knock down that Jay. Prolific scorer.
Maryland Player of the Year in 1996. Well, watch McClain against Davis. Boy, McClain is just so physical. Yes, a little short on that one.
McClain's going to fit perfect in Lon Kruger's system. High percentage shots and good defense.
Bruner and Guess, McClain with the block. Bruner gets it back. Boy, does he get his hands on the ball a lot. Shooting a bad percentage, but he is so incredibly active, he calls the timeout.
Yeah, he was an active player. But you're right, his shooting percentage is down because he takes a lot of really off-balance shots.
Take a timeout with 4:58 to go. West leading 74-57 at Magic's Round Ball Classic from Auburn Hills. Ground ball classic, West dominating thus far, 74-57, Dick Vitale.
Well, we're with Chris Wallace right now as we look at Ricky Davis with that little jam. I really like his athletic ability and his mobility. We're here with Chris Wallace. He's from the Miami Heat, a scout, does a heck of a job. Also writes a lot of articles for several publications, including the Dick Vitale yearbook.
Let's get a plug in there, Dick.
Well, Chris, great having you here.
Appreciate it.
Hey, what's your interpretation watching some of these young players right now?
Well, as usual in these type of national events, there's a lot of talent and athleticism out there. But it's been my experience evaluating talent in a lot of different venues and for different organizations. You can get too high or too low on kids off these All-Star games. I remember the Dapper Dan back in Pittsburgh in the early 80s. Steve Alford, I believe, only scored about 2 points. But he becomes an Olympian and a national champion. So
all-time leading.
That's right. So you got to be careful. A lot of times the team-oriented kids who aren't the greatest athletes get left behind sometimes in these settings.
Yeah, becomes an up and down. Let us go right now to Tracy McGrady, who has declared for the NBA. What's the general feeling among all the scouts that you travel with in terms of an evaluation of McGrady and where he will project into the NBA draft?
Well, there's some intrigue, Dick, about Tracy McGrady because you've got a kid in the 6'9 range who's very long-armed, who can handle the ball, who is athletic, explosive, gets to the basket, completes his plays. Obviously, before he becomes a force in the NBA, he's going to have to do a lot of work in the weight room, build up that body, also groove that outside shot. It seems like the kids today who are gifted athletically and get to the basket easily, a lot of times the shot follows behind their athleticism. So it's going to be a long process for him before he can become a dominant game in and game out contributor. But at the same time, it looks right now from most of the reports I've seen from the other scouts and the media that he's got an excellent opportunity to go in the first 15, 16 picks somewhere.
Yeah, I would think so as well. That's the general feeling we seem to be getting from people, and it'll be probably in the middle of the first round and project there. Who else has impressed you here watching some of these kids early and kids that you follow throughout the year?
Well, the Davis kid out of Iowa, I'm going to be very excited to see him in that up-tempo system that Tom Davis uses so well with the Hawkeyes. And remember, he has a teammate coming in.
Dean Oliver,
who's one of the top high school point guards in the country. He's not here tonight. That's quite a recruiting catch for Iowa. The McLean from Priory, Illinois, is headed to
Illinois.
Yeah, to Fighting Illini. Lon Kruger is going to do a great job there. He's got a body. Reminds me of a guy that plays a little bit for our team, Tim Hardaway. That type of linebacker's body on a 6-foot guard. Johnson from Utah. I mean, I've heard some of the people up in the stands saying they see a little Keith Van Horn in him. And you know, Rick Majerus, who does a super job developing the individual skills of his players, is going to do quite well with him in the WAC.
Well, you know, Lamar Odom declared today for UNLV. Certainly Billy Bano smiling, Rick Pitino a little bit sad. Were you surprised? Because early reports were that he was going to go to the NBA draft.
Well, it's sort of a Truman Dewey deal. You remember the headline back in the election? I fly into Detroit today, and the front page of the sports page has him going to Kentucky. Then I get here, and they said, well, he's going to UNLV.
Yeah, he announced for UNLV. I think he made a great decision. I'll tell you, Chris, I'm really upset about the fact that kids are making that transition. I don't blame the kids. I blame the NBA. I agree with Billy Packer. I think it's time for the executives, and I'm not certainly talking about the scouts. You guys are doing your job. But I think that the NBA execs got to sit down with the NCAA and come up with a game plan, because I hear the argument that the baseball rule will not work in the NBA. I'm not convinced of that. They've made it work in baseball because Major League Baseball has gotten together, because I think the NBA gets hurt and the kids get hurt.
Chris Wallace, our guest here in the Miami Heat, along with Dick Vitale. I'm Dave Simpson. Go ahead and respond to that.
Well, I've got to defend the NBA here, Dick. Certainly, no one wants to see a mass exodus of kids coming out of high school. It's not good for any of the parties involved, either the league or the college game, if you're going to get a lot of kids coming out before they're physically and emotionally ready. But at the same time, you put the onus on the NBA. There's also got to be something done in terms of getting these kids in a more respectable situation in their own institutions. Everybody's making great money in the game on the college level, particularly the coaches. I see all the coaches of the Final 16 teams all got new deals, the network contracts over $1 billion for the 7 years, whatever. whatever it is, or shoe money out there, seat licensings I see with the new college arenas. The kids have got to get something back to this. And I think to address this issue without bringing up the fact of the financial inequity and how the revenue is distributed in college basketball is not going to solve anything. That has to be addressed.
I agree with you there, but the bottom line is what turns me off is when I hear NBA execs say we don't entice these youngsters to come out. In essence, when you're placing millions in front of a young kid who's economically in a situation at home where he's not coming from a family that has a lot of dollars available, like, let's say, for example, some kids that have stayed 4 years, the Grant Hills and right down the line, David Robinson, the Bob, not that they had a lot of money, but they came from families that were pretty stable financially. My point I'm making is they got to meet with the NCAA, and something has to come up. I agree with you. I think players deserve some money. I've said this from day one, but I really also believe that a plan has to be adopted by both, because the NBA gets hurt and the NCAA gets hurt and everybody, and most of all, I think a lot of kids get hurt. We talk about Marbury making it and we talk about Allen making it, but what about the Kingsburys and the Jason Osbournes and I could go on with a list, the Anderson Hunts, the Scotty Thurmans, and all of those that come out and have this false illusion and they don't make it.
Well, you're right. There's some kids that decide to come out early that obviously should have stayed in school. You'll see that every year. But I don't know how you can legislate, Dick, to keep kids from themselves, so to speak. I mean, it's an opportunity out there that some are going to take that probably should, and it's not necessarily their time. But, again, I go back to so many things that need to be addressed. In particular, I see now coaches can move on, but the kid who signed early.
I addressed that.
You talk about that.
I addressed that 5 minutes ago. I think that rule is ludicrous, absurd. I'll tell you what I'd like to see, Chris, and I'll never probably
I just
happen.
Would like to see, Dick, some rules that benefit the kids. It seems to me most of the rules benefit the administrators, the institutions, and the coaches. I see very few rules out there that that help the kid. And let's face facts, we're not in the Chip Hilton era anymore. We're close to the 21st century. It's a whole new ball game out there, and you almost need to have like an armistice and some sort of peace conference where all the sides can come together, and the athletes also have a seat at that table.
I agree. I've talked about that so many times. I'd like to see, and I've said it to David here, the NBA, watch a Cham and a follow by Eli, subsidize a league of all young kids that want to come out of high school, a rookie league, like in baseball and hockey, they do it, go to a minor league, because we have a problem in college athletics that we better face reality. Both in football and basketball, we have too many kids that don't want to be there academically, have no desire to be there. They're only there because the system says that's the step, and I hope to go to the next level. I think if we had a league where they learned a vocation, learned a trade, and played in a minor league, and they did their thing, and the kids that go to college really want to be there, that would solve all the problems.
No, I agree with you. Some sort of step like that needs to be introduced. And right now we have the CBA, which does a terrific job, more geared in some ways to some of the older players, although Ronnie Fields, who's a kid that certainly falls in that category, and played in the CBA this year, got into a professional setting. But you're right. We need more opportunities for the youth. Again, I know Tom Davis and all the Hawkeyes are smiling there.
Oh, if he's as good as, I mean, he is as good as advertised, and if his buddy is as well, Dean Oliver, and Jess Settles comes back from an injury, they're going to have a great, great year. Chris, we'll get away from all the philosophy now. I know you a long time, and I know you love the game. Hey, Miami, you guys are doing a great job. Pat Riley's got that program so up-tempo now in terms of the excitement when I say up-tempo in the community. You guys have done a great job.
It's been a super year into the Miami Heat. Pat Riley, I can't say enough good things about him. I mean,
he's your boss.
You know, the Michelangelo you always say about Dean Smith on the college level, he's certainly the Michelangelo of the pro level.
All right, Chris Wallace from the Miami Heat. Good to see you, Chris.
Thanks a lot, Chris, for joining us.
And we'll take a break here at the end of three quarters. It's 93-70 to the West leading here at the Round Ball Classic. Fourth quarter action here with the West dominating 93-70. Dick?
Yeah, I'll tell you right now, we're watching the Jam right there by Eli, who's had a lot of those today. I think the star of stars early, though, has been that, I mean, in the first half was Ricky Davis, and he continues to impress with some of the things he does on the floor.
All right, we've got Chris Burgess back in the game.
Finally got a touchdown in the low box, got fouled, no call.
Got fouled by Saunders, and Lamar Odom came in right before we came back on the air and said, hey, we got to make a game of this. He's getting blistered here by 23.
Well, he's sitting on a pine a lot, not getting a whole lot of PT, playing time. I know one thing, now UNLV, he'll get a lot of PT.
Immediately.
They're going to have some club down there. I love that Keon Clark in terms of blocking shots, what a shot blocker. Isaiah Epps is eligible next year. Kevin Simmons, a transfer, outstanding prospect. Did well at Cal Irvine.
Khalid El-Amin, who played well, so well in the second half, second quarter rather, back in the game. He's got 9 points.
Some interesting points, though, by Chris Wallace.
Yes,
he really made some really good, solid points. Addressed that same issue we talked about, the youngsters there. Whereas we look at Melvin Eli, 24 big ones today. He's an MVP candidate, no doubt about it.
Along with Ricky Davis, he's got 27. Turnover, here comes Lamar Odom for the East. He's it for Anthony. Anthony's going to pull up for, it was a deuce attempt. Glover takes over for the West. Glover in traffic, shoots behind, and he's good job, Deion Glover.
He can really score. If he gets in that lane, he's got the strong body. He knows how to finalize and finish.
11 points for Glover out of Decatur, Georgia.
Met his mom and dad, shared some time with them. Last night at the banquet, all the moms and dads and the guardians and the friends and the grandmothers were all on cloud nine taking pictures with the Irvin, the Magic Man.
Anthony with the putback is good.
Byron Anthony, Fletcher High School, Kentucky bound. What a job Tito did this year with that club. Losing four guys from a team that went to the won the national title the year earlier as we watch another jam.
Nice follow there for the East by Terrence Morris, the forward out of Frederick, Maryland, with the Thomas Johnson High School.
So tough that they lost Derek Anderson, but what a salute to Arizona to beat three number one seeds. A salute and a tribute to Lute Olson and certainly Mr. Simon, I think Miles Simon. I sat on a plane flying back with his grandmother, and she was so proud. She said, you look at my grandson's arm, the tattoo, HLS. That's Helen Loretta Simon. That's me. And then his sister was on a plane as well. Sister married to Daryl Strawberry.
Yes, indeed. Daryl off to a tough start. So as of yesterday, was 0 for 10 at the plate thus far, but a lot of faith in him in New York this year. El-Amin to the hole. And boy, the little guys are really penetrating a lot.
El-Amin, that's a big gap there. You don't see the kind of defensive pressure on a basketball they'll see on a collegiate level.
Here's Lamar Odom. Started out of Christ the King High School, then went to Redemption Free Academy in upstate New York, and now in Connecticut at St. Thomas Aquinas.
Well, he's trying to get his core curriculum so he can be eligible. He has the ACT scores, but he needs to get his core curriculum classes.
97-76, the West in command here at Magic's Round Ball Classic. Glover beat three men, then blew the shot.
Did a great job beating those three with that little dribble penetration. Change of direction. Lamine's got a great change of direction as well.
Left it underneath for Morris.
Terrence Morris brings a smile to Gary Williams' face. There goes Mr. Glover, little Jam City.
One quick pass, and he got a finished out at the other end, 99-78.
I could have scored in that situation. Nobody rotated back.
Not like these guys don't know how to either, you know? Oh, nice block. McGrady, big send back. And look at El-Amin. Burgess going to get a chance.
Yes, Chris Burgess with a little jam. He'll be a big factor down at Duke. You can count on it. He'll fit into that system perfectly.
Burgess with nine, his first field goal of the second half. Saunders. Nice play by McGrady to knock it off of Odom.
McGrady certainly has shown a lot of good skills watching him here today. You could see the things that Chris Wallace was talking about. The upside at 6'9", very young. He's got to fill out that body, but he's got the agility, mobility, the good handle. He's like a point forward. I mean, he really has got great handling skills.
Got fouled by Odom. It's almost like a mirror image of each other, McGrady and Odom.
Yeah, they really are, except one's righty, one's lefty. Yeah. It's unbelievable. You're right. Good call right there.
7:01 to go in our ball game here. Dave Sims and Dick Vitale with you, the Magic's Round Ball Classic. I want to thank Sonny Vaccaro and his lovely wife Pam for all the work that they have done regarding this game. And Sonny, of course, originated this game as a Dapper Dan Classic back in 1965 in Pittsburgh. But a couple of great people, and they have just done a fabulous job for all of these young people.
Oh, what a job they have done in the planning, the travel, arrangements, and all the goodies and the banquets. And his wife, Pam, she works around the clock. Unbelievable. And then also people like Tracy Morris and John Dillon and Pam DeCesar, all very active and all really showing a lot of compassion and caring for the young kids that are playing to give them a first-class event. I mean, everything here is like quality.
Oh, no
from
question.
Everything, from the food, from everything, uniforms, the banquet.
From the site, it's a great arena. Palace at Auburn Hills, 6:47 to go in the fourth quarter. It's 101-78. The West totally dominating here. See what kind of response the East might have in the final 6:47 when we come back. High school all-star basketball, the Round Ball Classic. 101-78 West leading the East here. Dave Sims and Dick Vitale with you. And what about it? Can the East do anything to get back in this game or what?
I guess Round Ball belongs to the West this year when you look at what Arizona did.
Daniels. High arching flip shot. Mouton, boy, he did a little everything. Flip shot, grabbed some jersey of Morris.
Well, maybe that's a sign what's going to happen in the NBA, too. Now we had the West with Arizona. We got the high school All-American game with the West. Who knows? Maybe the NBA.
That's right. Third foul on Mouton. With the
rock. Mouton and certainly Glover being available in El-Amin. Most kids signed early, though, as I indicated a little bit earlier in that Bob Gibbons report out of the top 100 kids, 85 had committed early or signed.
Why do you see that becoming a trend now?
Because I think kids are more aware, as Bob said in his report, about the necessary scores you have to get on your tests and your academics, and they're working toward that a little bit more and more preparation involved in those areas.
Myron Anthony with the charge. That is his fourth foul. His first foul, my mistake. His first foul. Another look.
We're going to watch a drive to the goal.
Grady Daniels stayed his ground nicely. Deion Glover.
Oh, yeah.
Tipped up and in.
What hands. McGrady with the little tip.
And Saunders right back. They're going to love that in Gamble Pavilion up in Stores, Connecticut.
They'll have a block and a roll. Richard Hamilton and company, South Block. They got a lot of good super Souths up there. I think the kid Freeman is going to be an outstanding player. Played with Tim Thomas. Then a little fake. A little showtime. He's got a little pizzazz, a little showtime in him.
Got the juice. No doubt about it. He's got 12 points. Four here in the second half.
Oh, yes. Glover says, anything you can do, I can do better.
6'4", 235. They look like good size.
He looks like a linebacker. I'll tell you, very agile.
A little too high on the ladder for Chris Burgess from Greedy Daniels.
And the slam dunk competition hasn't even started yet.
I like that name, Greedy Daniels. He's got more tattoos than Dennis Rodman all over his body.
It's unbelievable. How did El-Amin get that? How did he get
that? I think he's got,
all over.
He's got that flair about him, El-Amin, to make that spectacular play.
He looks like he's absolutely murder on defense. If you've never seen him before, can you imagine going out and playing him for the first time? Burgess.
Oh, nice fake.
Yes, it was.
Nice fake.
Dukies will love that.
He's great catch. Great finish.
Got 11 points. Father said he's a very accomplished pianist, too. So he could go to school on a music scholarship.
El-Amin shoots it in. Clem Haskins winks.
Nods his head. Young man, come on and stay home in Minnesota.
Wait a minute, they're saying, hey, we got him down to Hoya Land, down to Georgetown. Connecticut says we want him. Kansas wants him.
I heard Big John was here. I didn't see him yesterday, but I heard him.
Oh, yes, nice little feed.
He's Myron got great, Anthony.
Great passing ability. That's what I like about Odom, his passing ability. It's dunking time. Who needs a slam dunk contest? They might as well have one right now.
That's right. Make that El-Amin get some two guys, three guys, puts it up, nothing there. And here comes the West. They got a 4-on-2. Mouton.
Mouton with that nice touch. He can really stroke the jumper.
Good looking shot. He's got 7.
He's got a nice touch. Squares the body really well. I can see why NC State, Kentucky, Tulane all want him. Arkansas. Oh.
Look for Arkansas to bounce back next year.
Well, you know, they got a nice cast coming back. I think the NIT situation helped them. Good young players coming back. There's El-Amin, that little fake. I mean, it's amazing how they devise all these little maneuvers, little shake and bake time.
Fourth foul on Mouton sends Odom to the line. Amar with just one bucket. 2 on free throws. Check that, 2 free throws for 2 points. And this is big day. He's decided to attend the University of Nevada, Las Vegas.
surprised everybody. I think everybody thought yesterday in the lobby the word was Kentucky, Kentucky, Kentucky. But he really, in fact, the paper today wrote in the paper that it was Kentucky here in the Detroit Free Press and News. But bottom line is, he said he really felt comfortable in their environment at UNLV, and he really enjoyed himself when he visited, and he decided to play for the Running Rebels. And Billy Baino, their coach, has a smile walking around this arena like you cannot believe. Former assistant to John Calipari.
Greedy Daniels from McGrady. Boy, they had that one set up.
And the little guy finishes it off. He usually is the guy initiating the slam dunk with the pass, Daniels. He's going to be a good player down there at UNLV, Daniels.
There's Mouton.
He can stroke it now. He can stroke it.
Didn't get enough on that one.
Levine wants the rock. Give me the rock.
Go for the alley-oop. Broken up by Mouton.
He's got Burgess. He's got Burgess. Oh,
he Levine just took it right away from him. Got some elevation here on this floor today.
Saunders, Mr. Basketball in Connecticut with the finish.
Saunders with 10 points. Four here in the second half.
I'm out of Waterbury, Connecticut. Holy Cross High School.
Glover adds to his totals. He's got 17.
He's just a big time scorer.
Odom. Missed there. Morris follows.
Terrence Morris on a glass. You look at Maryland's players that are coming back with Obina Akizi on the inside and Stokes and Profit, and you add Morris, they're going to be a solid glove.
Calling a jump ball. Glover attacking the glass there. 2:33 to go. We've got a timeout on the floor with the West leading 116-94 here in the Magic Round Ball Classic from Auburn Hills. All-star action. Check this out. McGrady to Daniels. Big guy to the little guy.
Yeah, it's reverse right there. This little guy showing his ability to go up, up, and away. Little greedy Daniels, little jam city. As McGrady showing his passing ability, flips it up. And there's Daniels with the finish and a flush.
The East is getting spanked here. 116-94. Lamar Odom. Alley-oop attempt. This is looking like the game the other in the Final Four. Who was it, the Carolina game when they went for all the alley-oops in the first few minutes?
Yeah, early in the game they did that. They went for all those dunks, and then Arizona shut that down, made an adjustment defensively. North Carolina's got some good kids coming in. Brendan Haywood next year, and also Max Owens. Something to be a solid player. Brian Burstiker is a kid that they say will be a little bit of a project, a seven-footer. Down the road will be a very good player with work, and certainly in that Carolina system, he'll learn.
There's Morris from Odom. Good look by Lamar Odom.
Morris got another guy coming in, Juan Dixon, who they say is going to really be a help for them down at Maryland.
Burgess from way outside. He hit one earlier in the first half from about 30 feet. There's Anthony. Saunders. Oh, lost a handle on the way up.
Got a little show on, reversing the basketball. These kids really are just having a lot of fun out here. That's what it's really about. It's not about statistics. It's not about all the drama in terms of the offenses and defenses and a scheme of things that happens in a normal game. It's just displaying your ability to run up and down the floor.
Best play with the best. And a nice reward for a fine career.
Chris Burgess with the tip.
Ended up with 13. He's got 13 points.
It's going to be really nice. If Elton Brand, who I have not seen, is as good as advertised. They tell me from Peekskill, New York, real power guy down in a box inside. Shane Battier, they're going to like. Very versatile. There's Deion Glover. Champ City, give him a 10. Duncan time.
Glover with 19. You're going to like Elton Brand, because the attacks the basket down on the low post are going to really like it.
They got an outstanding guard coming in as well as William Avery. Yeah. So Duke's got that tremendous class. So the UNLV stock has gone up. Their class with the agreement of Odom to wear a Running Rebel uniform. Wake Forest got a nice class coming in. Robert O'Kelly, Rafael Vitoretta. Out of prep school, New Hampton Prep. So Davy Odom's got a nice class.
About Saunders, he wrote in Slam Magazine, kept a diary, very informative stuff, young man.
Yeah, they said he did a great job, the kid from out of Holy Cross in Waterbury, in writing that diary.
Boy, Ellen Mead, boy, he's just all out.
all over the floor. I mean, we're seeing absolutely no defense at all. You and I can run out there and score right now, Dave.
Just give a guy a high sign. Right? Just give a guy a high sign. My turn.
Yeah, that's what it is. My turn.
Daniels, Burgess. Boy, he's been waiting for that all game.
Yeah, Burgess.
Finally recognized him down along the low box. Burgess with 15 points.
And that'll make that nice journey back to California feel nice.
Alameen showing can shoot the rock, too. That's going to do it.
It's all over, baby. I tell you, Dave, it's been a lot of fun being here. Enjoyed sharing some time with you at the banquet as well. It's just been a lot of fun.
Absolutely, Dick, and it's always a pleasure working with you. 124 to 106, the West dominating here at the Magic Round Ball Classic. Good weekend for these young people.
And there's the guy that's made it all happen from the moment he arrived, Irvin Magic Johnson. Brings a smile to everyone's face, rocked the arena, the banquet last night, the arena today when he walked in. He just has that special way. I tell you, you talk about a guy that absolutely electrified him when he was here in his state. 1979, winning a national title against Larry Bird in Indiana State. 77, winning a state championship. He's got the gold medal in terms of the Olympics, 5 NBA championships.
He has absolutely, positively done it all and continues to excel in the world of business. Melvin Eli, one of the players of the game. And Ricky Davis. And we'll take a timeout, come back and talk to our players of the game as we look at Sonny Vaccaro, still directing traffic here at Magic's Round Ball Classic. 124-106 the final. West on top.